Good afternoon, guys. It's November. It's the first day of the FM pass here in Davao. The first day back to FM. So I picked up my FM pass today so I can go out on Monday, Wednesday and Friday, which is a godsend because as of yesterday I didn't have an FM pass. I got rid of it. But this is where we are. So join me, guys. I'm going to turn around and talk today on the balcony about buying property. Hey guys, welcome back. Oh, there we go. So here on the balcony, and I was sitting down over the weekend and I'm just thinking about if FM comes, what am I going to be doing to create content for my YouTube channel? And somebody suggested to me that I should look at property prices, which I did on Saturday, Sunday and all day yesterday, and I had a little nose around the internet and what's going on. So today I'm just going to give you some what I can see is actually happening here in Davao and regarding buying property. Is it a good time to buy property in Davao? I would say yes, because there are a lot of people that can't afford to make the payments on what they purchased 2, 3 or 4 years ago, having a speculative outlook on getting rich by owning property and renting it out. Because the jobs have dried up, because nobody has any more money, because COVID-19 and the government are ratcheting down on what is going on, respectively about the scaremongering of people and COVID-19 and trying to prevent COVID-19 it's having the effect on the economy, and that effect on the economy is suppressing people's salary and what they can earn, which means what they signed up for on purchasing property over, you know, as I said, 2, 3, 4 years ago or even last year hasn't worked out. So What I'm going to turn around and do, I've taken all this information from a website called Lamundi, based in the Philippines, and you can get a snapshot. Majority of the properties I'm going to post pictures of at the end of this vlog have a 100 square meter plot size going up to 395 square meter plot size. Okay. The inside of the property goes from around 38 square meters to 55 square meters. Nice music in the background, isn't there? So that's it. The areas that I've actually selected are the areas that have a large increase, and I must say increase, because I did this vlog about 6 months ago about buying property, and there was very few. You know, there was about 5 or 6 in the bottom under 3 million peso properties. Now there is 19 pages. 19 pages of property. So it's just showing you that people were investing in property. Now they can't afford to make that payment. Now they're actually moving and they're getting off the property ladder. Which means there's a lot of houses that are out there. I will cover condominiums this week because there's a lot of condominiums going up, and I will cover rental. But this today is about sales. So I'll give you the price in peso and I'll give you the price in dollar, so you can actually do your comparison if you're thinking of coming out of here. The areas I looked at are Buhangin, Indang, Tolomo, Turil, Downtown, and Mintal. and I'm looking at my notes here because I need to look at my notes. The properties are with foundations, concrete foundations with rebar. They are with brick, or what they call out here, this block, which, you know, very, very basic, with a tiled roof, what they call a tiled roof. So the tiled roof may be tiles, may be metal. It's not down as bamboo or anything like that. So the houses are for sale. And over the last 12 months, 50,000 pesos per square meter is what you're looking at, okay, which is about $1,000 per square meter of a property that's finished. I don't think that's right. I think it's a lot lower than that. I think that is Lamundi trying to keep the property prices high, okay. So the properties that you're looking at when you go to see them, or you see them online, they'll turn around and say that they are a two bedroom or a three bedroom. They come with a bathroom, they come with a CR, they come with a dirty kitchen, which is outside, or they come with a kitchen inside. They have a living room, they have a porch, and they have parking for cars. Okay. And now, when you look at those adverts, you have to bear in mind that there are people that are doing a little bit of clickbaiting, shall we say, within their advert. So don't take it as gospel. What you need to look for is, you need to look for that at the size of the property, you need to look for that it's title free, you need to look for that its taxes have all been paid. You don't want to be incurring any taxes on somebody, because the first thing they'll stop paying will be taxes when they can't afford to make payments on the house. That's the first thing they'll stop. You need to understand it, make sure it's got water, drainage, electricity. You need to make sure that it's near a community. You don't want to be buying a property that's so far out in the town, it's in a flood area. You want to make sure that it's in a nice area. And the areas I've chosen for you there are nice-ish, let's put it that way. There are some really dodgy areas that you want to keep away from. Because they've got a high crime rate in certain areas, and crime goes up when people don't have any money, do they? So that's it. So the property prices I've got today are ranging from 890,000 peso, under 1 million peso, to 3 million peso, and about 200,000 pesos over that. And the reason I put those in is because it's got negotiable. Yeah, in their advert, which means if it's negotiable and you turn around and say, well, I'll give you three million for it, they're more likely to turn around and take it because they need the money. So bear that in mind when you're looking at it. I know everywhere else in the world has got COVID-19 and people are turning around and saying, oh, you know, we want to turn around and stay here, we want to do this, we want to buy this, we want to do that. But at the present time, in certain parts of the world, you could get your dream property for a million off what it was a year ago. A million off, that's a million pesos, yeah. So that's nearly, what would that be, about $150,000? Yeah, something to think about, isn't it? Because it's the future. If you have that resource, you can pay because you've got a job here. Jobs very, very difficult to get hold of. So what have I got here? Cheapest, oh yeah, so I'm going to put the pictures up from the cheapest property up to the most expensive, and you can look at them. And as I turn around and say, I did this about 6 months ago and I had around about 8 or 9 properties. I think today it's 25 to maybe 30 pictures of properties, okay. Now the other thing that's actually come to light in the last couple of months is the RFO means ready for occupancy, which means you can move in. The properties that you're going to see, you can move in, they're built. There are a lot of places here where they turn around and advertise a property and it's a picture, but it's a picture of a three-dimensional post, but it's not built yet. What they want you to do is give your money and then you have to wait. Properties here are up and ready to be moved into. Now, there are some properties here that have a caveat I've put into this, and they are like at Carmelite, or they are over at certain Nara, certain subdivisions. Now, what they turn around and say is it will cost you 8,000 pesos a month to buy this property. That's true, it will. However, you have to do some things before that to get the 8,000 pesos. Okay, so the properties I'm going to talk about, these two specific properties at the moment, are rent to buy. Okay, which means you put a deposit down around 25,000 pesos, and it's the same for both the subdivisions. And then within 6 months, you have to pay around 500 to 600,000 pesos. Okay, that gives you a deposit or a reservation. That gives you your commitment to the purchase, and then you have a figure that is left, which could be between 1,500,000 to 2,100,000 pesos. Sorry about that. And that then is put into a mortgage at 6% fixed, not variable, fixed. Okay, for a term of either 20, 25 or 30 years. If you took for 30 years, it will cost you 8,050 pesos a month for 30 years. Or you can go to 9,500 for 25 years. Or you can go just over 10,000 pesos a month. Now, that is a good deal, really, considering if you're going to move here and you're going to retire and you have a Filipino girlfriend, you can rent a property and the rent could go up. Okay, so you could start at 10, 12, 15 and 20,000. Whereas if you're with your girlfriend or your partner and you buy a property and you start paying the rent isn't going to go up because it's fixed. It's a fixed price. The only downside is if you want to turn around and try and sell that property at a later date, it could be quite difficult because there is no high disposable income in Davao at the moment. Everybody is holding on to their money. So that is a ready to buy that you can actually see on Lamundi, which means you put in initial deposit, within 6 months you make your payment, and then that's interest free. You just make that payment. And then you then start your payment of the loan you've taken out. And there's three types of loans. There's a Filipino big bank you can do it through your normal bank, or you can do it through a mortgage operator. But the interest rates are set at 6 because they're trying to stimulate that growth. Fix, I've done that. Properties, yeah, you need to make sure it's got water. Christ, that's expensive to turn around and try and plumb in. You need to make sure the titles are clean. There is nobody behind the scenes trying to extract more money out of you. Yeah, you've got to have it happen. It needs to be taxes all paid. You don't want to be taking on debt for somebody else that's been living there. They need to clear the debt and clear the road for you. Electricity needs to be there, because to move electricity, it's about $35 a meter here to move an electrical cable from the road to your house. Drainage, it needs to have good drainage. It needs to go into a good septic, or it needs to go into the main sewage system. Me personally, I would like to have a property that's on a slight elevation, but it's going down away from you, because I don't want flooding coming up. It needs to turn around and be close to the services and the transports. So it needs to be close to banks, it needs to be close to pedicabs or jeepneys or bus routes. It doesn't need to be close to the airport, but it needs to be in that region, okay? So, as I said, I did this a couple of months ago, or 6 months ago, and I've noticed a big increase. And I have to say, a big increase. Not just on Lamundi, but also on other websites that are here, pushing for property, and they are pushing quite heavily to turn around and sell these properties. For me, I think it's a good thing. There are some nice areas that are here. Bullhanging is a nice area. It's close to City Mall, it's close to the airport, it's close to the country, and it's raised so you can actually look over Davao. Okay. Tolomo is over by Davao River. It's in the lowlands. It's got a tendency in some areas to flood, but they're putting that right by putting in water drainage and runoff areas into the river. And some of the properties there are quite nice. They look very, very presentable. At Tiril, there are some nice properties over in Tiril, especially if you're getting a little bit inland. I wouldn't suggest living close to the sea, so I've not put any of the properties that are in the subdivisions that are close to the beaches on that area, because the beaches get frequented and parties, and there is no like legislation, and it just becomes like a big free-for-all. Nice to go to on a day, but you want to go home and have some peace and quiet at night. You don't want to be listening to music all the way through the night, do you? Really? You don't want people partying all the time and scooters and jeepneys and taxis running up the road that you're living on. So I've kept it inland, and it's cooler when it's inland. It's cooler. So hopefully you all like it, guys. Give us a thumbs up if you do. As I said, lockdown is here, and I've got 3 days a week on the balcony. So the blogging in the balcony is going to take a little bit more time, because I need to turn around and find some creative content that I can post so you guys have something to watch, really. Today is about house prices. The bracket that I've gone from is 890,000 to 3 million, just above 200,000 over. There are properties in the range from 5 million to 35 million pesos on the properties, and those properties are luxurious, and they will turn around, and if they're on a subdivision, you will have to look at your management fees within the subdivision. So management fees for this subdivision are 5,000 pesos a year for an apartment. For a house, it's near 20,000. So the management fees in a subdivision could push you over your budget. Bear that in mind before you actually step into a subdivision and you go, I like that house, it ticks all my boxes. Look at the management fees that are sitting here that nobody's going to talk to you about. You need to ask the question about this. Always make sure you get an attorney or a solicitor involved in your purchasing to cross the T's and dot the I's. Remember that the solicitor works for you, not for anybody else. You are the one paying his the salary, so you need to ask him all the questions, and he needs to make everything crystal clear. Okay? Don't do anything without a contract. Don't do anything without something written down. Okay? If somebody turns around and says to you that, oh, I've got a friend of a friend of a friend that can find you something that's in this price bracket, don't even go there, guys. Walk the other way. Might be a lovely person, yeah, walk the other way. Okay, do not go down that route of a friend of a friend of a friend. Because there'll be a friend will put $1,000 on it, another friend will put $1,000 on it, another person will put $1,000 on it, and then they'll turn around and say, well, I've got a foreigner involved, and then all of a sudden the start price goes up by $1 million. And then all of a sudden you're in this never-ending circle where three people all have a different opinion of what you're talking about. They're telling other people, yeah, they're really, really interested. This foreigner's really, really, and you're not interested. And they'll just keep pestering you and pestering you and pestering you and pestering you and bugging you. So don't go down that route. Get yourself a solicitor. Stick the solicitor on the table and turn and say, everything goes through you. Everything goes through you. And get that solicitor to become your mediator and become your broker, but also become your voice. Because what the Philippine people do not like to turn around and do is they don't like confrontation. And they won't turn around and go and have a conversation with a solicitor. because the solicitor will be talking law, and the person that's actually talking to them will be talking about chismes or something else he's heard on the website or something she's seen on Facebook or something they found on Twitter. Okay, so it will be this conjecture. Get it all on the table, all up front before you make a decision. Okay, so have a look. Hopefully you'll find it interesting. I am, as I said, I have noticed a sharp increase. Lots of properties going on the market.